Welcome back.
Thank you.
I'm always so happy to have you here. Congrats on the film.
Thank you.
Very exciting. This film has, unlike the first two, has some actual action sequences.
Yes.
Fight scenes.
Yeah.
Car chases.
Yeah.
I assume you have a stunt double. You weren't chasing your own cars in the film?
No, well, I did some of this driving.
You did?
Yeah.
Are you a good driver?
I'm a really, really good driver.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
And this has always been true of you?
Well, I think that if my acting career fails, that I will either be a florist or I could be a professional race car driver.
Really? Those are two very different paths. Yeah. I feel like there are no race car drivers currently who are like, it was either this or florist.
You don't know them.
I don't know them. That's true. I've talked to
you
none of them.
You
know what? I apologize to everyone in the race car industry. Do you have a pickup truck?
Yeah.
That is your real life car.
Yes, I have an F-150. It's a 95 F-150.
How did you come about having a 95 F-150?
It was my grandfather's truck, and before he passed away, my dad got him a new truck, so he gave me the old one. So I had it brought out to L.A., and it just is kind of a nightmare.
What part of it is a nightmare?
Well,
just that it's really
big
old?
And slow. It's like a beater truck. You just cruise around in it.
Do you use it for hauling? Are you someone who does their own hauling?
Yeah, I haul so many stuff.
I will say, because there's... I always see, like, stars are just like us, and it's like Dakota's hauling again.
There she is, hauling old George out of the ditch again.
Oh, you haul people... You drive around L.A. and just pull people out of ditches.
Yeah, I tow people.
I've heard that about you. You're like a Johnny Appleseed, but of towing people out of holes.
Or if you need me to move your furniture.
This is... you guys filmed the second and third movies at the same time.
Yeah.
Was that more fun, more interesting, or more difficult?
It was tricky because we had to go back and forth between, obviously, both movies because some locations would be the same, and then we kind of did all of the sex scenes at the same time.
Okay. I don't know why people are cheering. If I think about all the sex I've ever had at the same time, I'm like, oh, that's not, I don't want that. I want a long, nice break.
But it also took a minute. They were like, woo!
Yeah. They were like, I don't know how I feel about it.
What to do? She said sex. Oh, my God. But we do them all at back to back pretty much because they're in the same locations. So then
bedrooms and stuff?
Yeah. and so you want to try to, like, mix it up and not have them all be the same, you know?
Yeah. Well, yeah, you would. I mean, it would, like, kind of ruin the whole idea of 50 Shades if it was, like, the same kind of sex.
One shade.
One shade. Well, you guys are married in the final. So now it is. It's one shade from here on out.
Yeah.
50,
she is
50
bored. She is resigned.
50 Shades, the party's over.
Yeah. 50 Shades of...
You filmed in a home that it was Sarah McLachlan's actual home.
We shot in Sarah McLachlan's house, and she came to visit, and she sang a song on the piano, which was so funny to me. Only because I got really uncomfortable because it was a very serious moment, and I'm the person that is the person that laughs in the serious moments. So I was just in a complete giggle attack, and then when that happens, I cry.
Okay, gotcha.
So then it just looked like I was really emotional about In the Arms of an Angel.
You came full circle.
The ASPCA commercial. Yeah,
it was already a sad song, and then they married it to images of really upset animals.
Yes.
To the nth degree sad.
Yes.
It would be a terrible song to laugh through.
Right, which is what I did.
Okay, but she never knew until this moment.
Until right now, and I'm so sorry.
you grew up in Aspen. Are you a skier?
Wait, I have to make it clear, though, that I wasn't laughing at her, because I do think she's brilliant. I was laughing because it was like all my crew, and we're filming 50 Shades Freed, and then Sarah McLachlan's on the piano, and so the whole thing was really weird.
Yeah, no, random. I mean, that's a decent cover story.
Okay.